have been going on. Starting off, you know, Team Revenge played Prophecy, and that game was absolutely insane. It was a great game, and TR ultimately managed to win that game, so that puts them in the winners final.
Dude.
Yes.
Team Revenge.
Dude, that's the best way of explaining it.
They've been breaking out. They started online.
It's a great event for them. It really is.
You saw them kind of making their way there. Then at the North American Regionals, they really made everyone take notice of them. Look at their run so far. They took out FaZe Red. They took out the top squad from Australia, Mind Freak. Now taking out Prophecy, who beat Denial yesterday, and that means Revenge is going to lock in a spot to play either Denial or Automatic Reload in the upper finals to kick off the show tomorrow at 11 a.m.
That game is – the Denial AR game is going to be insane. Absolutely insane. That's a top-quality game, and honestly, I'm going to go out on a limb. Automatic Reload win that game.
It's going to be good, man.
It's going to be insane. It wouldn't amaze me at all with how they've been playing today. It's been insane. Same with Denial. That game has the Game 5 written all over it. It really does. And this is an Automatic Reload team, which neither yourself or Mr. X actually had coming out of group play.
I didn't think they were that good. I thought Anticity would crumble. He's crumbling. The whole squad is playing well.
However, will
they run out of steam against Denial? That's my big question, because Clay, Attach, JCap looking fierce.
But how this event is going?
I know you love AR.
I do.
But you want ARTR. It'll be really cute, Ben. But I don't see it happening. Let's go down to the lower bracket here. Upset Mania has caused this chaotic bracket. You can see Optic Gaming has already had to face off against Strictly Business. Meanwhile, FaZe Red, they dropped early. Had to play the winner of Envious versus Optic Nation. Really, I thought it should have been Nation. They struggled early on. They started off really strong, 2-0. Then they struggled early on in that Game 3. Game 4, they couldn't get it done. And then in that Search and Destroy, they had the lead. Quick restart of the game, weren't able to close it out as Saints took over the Search and Destroy and helped Envy fight for a top 12 finish.
And then you can kind of see where we are right now. You know, Optic Gaming playing FaZe Red. The winner of this will play the loser of that AR versus Denial game. Mind Freak versus TK. That's a good game. I kind of expect to see TK come through that one and play Prophecy in that round number 4.
Prophecy. You think...
They have played out of their minds.
You think they're done or they can go farther?
I think they're done by any means. I think they could go a little bit further. You know, you've been kind of on that Prof hype train for a while, and it's finally arrived. They have played amazing at this Scott Champs.
Of course, we still have the lower bracket round 4 and lower bracket round 5. Anyone in that lower bracket is not out of it yet. They're competing for not only the prize money, but of course, the Call of Duty Championship trophy. Who is going to take it here in 2015, as well as the Call of Duty MVP?
I want to hear an MVP chant from the crowd. Like, when someone makes a great play, I just want to hear them shout MVP. Me and some of the guys at Activision were talking about it. We're like, it'd be so cool to hear. Just the crowd chanting the MVP. And you see the two trophies there. They look absolutely awesome.
What it would mean to the players to take home the world championship today. You know it means the most to Eggs. He will never try harder than at the world championship. We saw what he could do last year, absolutely taking over games, just becoming a monster there right next to Crim 6. Now they're on opposite sides of that booth. Who is going to have the better game? Honestly, with all 8 players, incredibly talented people, I think, though, this is going to come down to Crim versus Aix. I just feel it before the match has even started.
I'm looking at the big fight between Slasher and Formal. I think that's going to be a big one as well. You know, who's going to win those battle fights? We've seen these two play Hardpoint Solar in the past, and it basically came down to Slasher just outslaying, helped his SMGs out so much by winning those long-range gunfights. But then you have, you know, Enable, Scumpy, those guys going toe-to-toe on the hill. And I guess if you want to call Parasite the objective player, him and Nadeshot trying to get those defense on the Hardpoints. When it comes to Search and Destroy, though, I think that's where FaZe Red can really excel. So this map one is going to be just so, so important. It really, really is. But that Crim Aix battle is going to be just ongoing throughout this whole series. Search and Destroy today, I've seen Aix clutching 1v2s and 1v3s. He's looked out of his mind.
That is the absolute closest I have ever seen the fan poll this weekend, guys.
Right?
Using the hashtag CODChampsLive. Let's get it trending worldwide. Optic Gaming, FaZe Red, only about 8% separating those two squads with the fan vote. We will see who is going to take this series. Ben, can I get your prediction before we begin?
I mean, it looks like map number one is going to be Biolab Hardpoint. So even more so than before, I think you're going to see some interesting plays come out of FaZe. I expect to see Parasite run the shotgun straight away. Maybe Naitrot pulls out the shotgun immediately for that first hardpoint. I'm going to say map number one is going to go to FaZe. I think FaZe may go 2-0 up into the series, and then potentially OG forcing game five.
Forcing game five and then yes. Not answering my question.
I know, it was a very sneaky tactic. I was trying to hope you would avoid picking that. Nah, I think Optic Gaming should win this.
Optic Gaming?
Yeah, I think Optic Gaming is going to win, but in all honesty, I hope it's just close. I just want to see a close, good game, because this is a game which a lot of people wanted to see. And just as you mentioned how close that fan vote was,
the green
wall were just like, well, we'll show you how this works. 73% to 27%.
I woke up the green wall. They are showing up strong to support their favorite team. Minutes away from game number one. If you're just joining us, every match on this stage will be a best of five. We're going to start things off with Hardpoint. Then we'll take it to Search and Destroy for game two. Game three and four will be either Uplink or CTF.
Yes.
And then if it gets to the game five tiebreaker, will always be SND. Is there a preferred SND squad on the main stage right now? Does either team have the advantage if it goes to that game five, in your opinion?
Phase. But then that's when you're going to see Crimsix come into just clutch mode. He's just going to go absolutely phenomenally out of his mind, clutch everything up. Because he will, this is the thing that people need to understand. When we talk about a rivalry, it isn't just kind of like some, I want to beat you. This is like, it means so much to these players. Krim does not want to lose to Aches. And that's the most important thing for him right now. And I expect to see off the break, I brought it up earlier on, Parasite with a shotgun and Naitrot with a shotgun. Has Parasite got one?
Yep.
He
secondary.
Does. Has Naitrot got a shotgun?
Yep, he makes it his primary, and he's also rocking Gung Ho. So if you guys want to play like Naitrot here, here is your class. The TAC-19 and right away going to be leading into the center.
And this is a really smart play. Naitrot knows. He knows Parasite is going to do it. So you're going to, with the blue spawn, you know you're going to get to this first hard point quicker. So you can lock it down with that shotgun. So, honestly, Naitrot should be able to lock this down for a big chunk of time, especially when Scuppy's picking up two pieces like that. My lord.
I know you love it when we see the TAC-19, but I love it when I see Scuppy with the ASM-1 every single time. Scuppy just puts on a highlight reel. When I'm making top five, it's really just looking at Scump clips for an hour to decide which one was the best.
Well, there's that shotgun coming to effect, and FaZe yet to get a single point here on that hardpoint. As I say, they finally managed to break onto that hardpoint. However, with 10 seconds left, got to be thinking about that rotation. And it currently looks like it is going to be Optic Gaming who have that snow spawn. They've got it pretty much locked down. FaZe are going to have to do a good job of trying to break over that.
Aches getting shut down early on, but Slasher is coming to life. And that's really what I was worried about. Slasher, an off series on the main stage earlier. How is he going to perform in the opening minutes against Optic Gaming? It's really going to set the tone for the team. Aches inside the hard point is going to win a big one-on-one. He's on a three streak. Grenades going out, trying to buy his teammates time to get back into position. Enable rotating through the middle is going to be the first one to get the cutoffs, and he's going to find a player up top. Nice call outs here. Good communication as it's FaZe Red maintaining control.
And what's going to be really interesting is we haven't seen this matchup where Aches has been playing good. The last couple of events, Aches hasn't been playing at his best. And now I think he's starting to get back up there with some of the plays he's been making today, and that's going to make it even closer. And he really is a player to keep your eye out for on this FaZe Red squad. He's actually currently on that hard point, has a player very tagged up. It's going to be Naitrot trying to push him, but Crimsix picks up the grenade.
And really, I'm looking at the battle players here as it's time to rotate. Slasher knows there's someone below, unable to get vision on him quite yet. Scump doing the damage indoors, but Slasher now rotating behind, gets one fully red. Will challenge, waiting for some help from Parasite. Both fall though. Aches now gonna press it by himself, and he is gonna be met by Scump. Fantastic hold so far by Scumpy, who opens up 14-5. We have to watch this man.
Yeah, he's on form. He's on a four streak right now. Almost a five. He actually falls on this hill, and this hard point is so big for teams. You can really generate a lot of time on this hill and build yourself a big lead or reduce massive deficits. As on board with Formal, he's going to try and break in. Drops, that's Parasite on the hard point for FaZe. Slash is going to clean up one, and FaZe looking at trying to pick up the remaining 20 seconds.
Big push being set up here from Optic Gaming. Crimsix could have just ran in. Instead, he's waiting on his teammates. Here they come, though. Slasher is going to find Krim in the window, just laying prone. Krim walked right in front of him. Slasher picks up a second, a third player around the corner. He gets the call out. It's Scump. Scump is taken out, and Slasher is melting everyone. We talked about Slasher needing to be the bow player. At this point, he's having so much success with the ASM1. Telling him, stick with the SMG. Let Enable take over that role.
100%. You know, 14 and 8, they needed someone to reply to the pressure that Scumpy was putting on these hardpoints. He's 18 and 8 himself, so realistically, that's the big battle ongoing in this map right now. Basically, Scump versus Slasher.
Slasher rotating around, but it's going to be Eggs kind of distracting Optic Gaming, giving Slasher the opening. Nice teamwork here from FaZe. Optic, though, sitting on top with a 20-point advantage. And after Scumpy, there's kind of a major drop-off
really
in the slaying here from Crimsix, Nadeshot, and Formal. I wonder what's going wrong for these guys.
And that's what makes it really interesting, because right now FaZe are out slaying, but they are still losing. And, you know, Scump's picking up so many of these gunfights on the hill. As Enable just shreds through Formal there. Fantastic accuracy coming out from him, but Crimsix replies with a two-piece of his own. And Scumpy on that hardpoint for Optic Gaming. But look how close this game is, Puckett. 89 to 84 as we rotate onto the final hardpoint of the first rotation.
Nice shots coming through. Enable has really turned up in the last minute and a half, dominating the kill feed, but it's Slasher left alive after some big kills from Krim and Formal. Formal's gonna break in, trying to get it going a little bit. 12 and 16, but on a three streak now. Can he continue to string these kills together? Player surging forward, and he is gonna find him with the headshots. Krim in the kill feed with Nadeshot as well. Everyone with the communication flowing here for Optic Gaming, trying to pull away, trying to give themselves a 20-point advantage, if not more.
And FaZe is unable to break this hardpoint. It's very rare you'll see a team completely lock it down for the full amount of time. And finally, FaZe are able to break in. Four players on the hill did so by pincing it from all angles, and Optic not really able to adapt to that. But we're going over to the first hill of the second rotations, and Parasite is ready and waiting, looking down ice with that ASM1.
It's crazy. FaZe Red broke the hardpoint. They all four get into BioLab. 4 seconds later, literally 4 seconds, Optic Gaming's back in, still scoring. And now you see Scump and Krim in the center of the map, continuing to lock it down. Scump 21 and 17. Krim was -5, brings that down to -2. Nadeshot on your screen has switched over to the HBR. Going over to the assault rifle here, and one that we don't see nearly as often.
Fan of this. He loves this assault rifle. You'll see him use it in Search and Destroy, Hardpoint. Loves pulling it out. It's very much a comfort thing. He definitely plays a little bit better, statistically speaking, when he's running that assault rifle. But right now, you know, you look at this score, 136 to 107. Formal on the Hardpoint. He's going to pick up one. Still 20 seconds left. That's a huge 20 points if FaZe are able to pick that up, and also a massive 20 points if Optic are able to increase that lead.
Big two-piece from Parasite, followed up by Enable and Aches. Parasite trying to stay alive inside. He's competing with Enable for the top score on the team. Both players doing everything they can in this hard point, but Captain Price, where is Aches so far? Can he get back going? He started off pretty warm, cooled off definitely in the last 2 minutes, but his teammates are making up for it.
He slowed down a lot, actually, but Enable on that hard point picks up one. But immediately falls. Parasite was in a position to just try and play for his life, but sadly couldn't make it happen, and Slasher's gonna drop as well. Optic Gaming really starting to pull themselves away here. 154 to 113. It doesn't look like anyone from FaZe is realistically gonna be breaking this hardpoint anytime soon. The kill's going all up to Gaming's way. They have three plays on the hardpoint, and this lead is gonna get out of control unless FaZe can stop it.
Nadeshot, here's the turret, gonna go chase down that kill. Meanwhile, it looks like it is Scump inside the hardpoint, continuing to do damage. Fantastic cover from Krim and Formal. Nothing but Optic in the kill feed as we have 12 points remaining. Scump should be able to get them all, and he actually is just going to be checking low, not going to see anything. All the major fights are going to go down across the map here, and really, if you're a FaZe fan, you have to get a full 60 points out of this next hardpoint.
It's essential. You know, you had to rotate a little early there. Optic completely controlled that Esky's hardpoint. And FaZe need to just kind of reduce their losses. They, as you said, you know, they rotated early. They've won the first couple of gunfights, but This is really where it's going to get a little bit more intense for them. Optic Gaming making a team push.
Enable set up right away, and he continues to score. Optic has not been able to break through or contest quite yet. As I say it, everyone's going to drop. FaZe getting right back in, though. Great rotations. Enable, can he watch the side? You've got Parasite with him as well. Slasher trying to do the damage over on purple side with Aches watching. Great big kills coming in from Aches and Slasher, and Enable is about to get pushed. But look at that scoreboard, Ben. FaZe is coming back in the final 2 minutes.
And they've held down this hard point for such a long time. However, Enable challenges and drops at least Parasite in a pretty awkward situation. Scumpy's actually team-killed Nature by accident there. 7 seconds left, and a 30-point lead, or just under that now for Optic Gaming as we rotate over towards Green Plat. But this is going to be the key. No one from FaZe able to rotate early enough. Optic Gaming get early control.
Doesn't matter though. Parasite and Aches clearing the way through the middle. I thought they were able to jump right in. I was dead wrong. Aches actually will break in. Slasher with the support, with the bow, but no one is inside scoring quite yet. Looks like Aches is going to jump right back in. We'll take our screen to him, and you'll see Nadeshot picks up Slasher. Will Optic be able to break through? That looks like they're going for a four-man push all through green, but there's a lot of eyes all in this direction for FaZe.
Oh, if Aches can stay alive here for a little bit longer, he's actually just picked up two. Phenomenal play from them, and FaZe are coming back into it. 198 to 187 as Aches picks up another kill on Nature. That's a sick streak for him. Players are going to be rushing him just from that bottom red side. He's going to pick up another one. That's seven.
No.
That could be eight for Aches. If he cleans that up, the assist comes in. Enable in a position to trade the kill. No, Nature picks it up. But there's Parasite. This game about to be tied with a minute left. Bucket.
Final 60 seconds, and FaZe has taken the lead. 203 and counting. It all comes down to this final hard point, the middle of the map. Four entrances. Who is going to be able to lock it down? Optic inside first. They tie up the score. Scumpy, last man alive, fighting against Parasite and Enable. Both players from FaZe breaking through. Neither team scoring as it's contested. This is going to come down to the wire.
Nature has it contested, looking for the second kill. He's not able to get it. You've got Slasher on the hard point. No. 29 seconds left. It's a completely tied game. Slasher picks up another kill. Players flooding in from all angles at this point. Parasite making FaZe have the lead here by just a few points. 20 seconds left in the game. Parasite drops. In goes Formal, in goes Natron, in goes Crimson from Optic Gaming. This is an insane ending to this game.
Scumpy trying to break through, and he was just cut down. All four members of FaZe inside. And FaZe Red is going to take game number one, the ridiculous comeback in the final 3 minutes.
What a comeback from FaZe. They were down by almost 60 points, maybe even more at a point in that
game. Oh, it was more.
That was ridiculous.
We said they had to get the full 60 on the blue hill. They got that. Aches goes on
that
a ridiculous 7-8 streak there. Top green to keep them in the game. And then it was a team effort in the final minute to lock it up. FaZe Red strikes first in the best of five. But this is going to be a long series. I have a feeling we're going the distance.
You know, you look at Aches' stats there, what, 31 and 36? Individually, not that impressive. But without that 7-kill spree on green, FaZe do not win that game. That's Optic Gaming winning map number one.
My MVP is without a doubt Enable and Parasite. Those two have been consistent from the first minute. They carried it through to the very end. Incredible game, though, from all eight players. We got another one coming up after this. Don't go anywhere. We'll be back with Search and Destroy.